All right, guys, we're gonna play some more Mafia 2. Let's get over to the game and continue.
Joe's pleasure, pal. It's Vito speaking.
Vito, why didn't you come home last night? I was worried sick.
Mama? I didn't know you had Joe's number. And whose phone is this?
So have you spoken to Mr. Pappalardo? Find yourself a job?
Yeah, he told me to come by and see him today. Hopefully he's got some work for me.
Okay, Vito. Good luck, mio bambino.
All right, bye, Mama.
Oh, hi there.
What's the matter? Nothing good on the radio?
Mind your beeswax, kid.
You don't turn that crap down! I'm gonna call the cops!
$45 to repair. All right. Oh, I didn't repair it.
The things you say will come out. And...
there we go.
It's almost always in back of your mind. You never know it until it's too late. And then you're in such a terrible state, like the moon jumps over the cow, hey diddle. That's the way the gypsy doodle works. When you think that you're crazy, you're the victim of the gypsy doodle. But it's not your mind that's hazy. It's your tongue at the more cut the noodle. You better listen and try to be true, and try to do all the things that you should. The gypsy doodle will get you someday. You'll think you're crazy, the things that you say, like rhythm got I and hot am I. That's the way the gypsy doodle works.
down! Close the door. It's windy. What do you want?
Yeah, I'm looking for a Mr. Papalotto.
Oh, yeah? Why?
My name's Vito Scaletta. My old man used to work for him, and I'm looking for a job, so I came here.
Well, you're in the right spot, sonny boy. Federico Papalotto at your service. You can call me Derek. I think I remember your dad. Good guy, but drank like a fish. What's he up to these days?
He's dead.
Oh, well, we all gotta go sometime. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
So you need a job, huh? Well, you're in luck. We just got a new shipment to unload. Steve will show you around. Now scram, my steak's getting cold.
Follow me. Load this pile of crates onto that truck. When you're done, you get $10. If something gets lost or broken, you get nothing. Start now and don't take all day.
Yeah, I'm done. And you can keep the $10. When I said I needed a job, I didn't mean slave labor.
Whatever. Get the fuck out of here, then. Don't show your face around here again.
Yeah, don't worry. I can make 100 times more working for Barbaro Incorporated.
Wait, you said Barbaro? Joe Barbaro?
Yeah, so what?
Shit. Nobody who works with Joe would carry crates for $10. What the hell are you doing? Come with me.
What now?
Well, this one don't like manual labor.
What the fuck?
Said he works with Joe Barbaro.
Bullshit. Who wanna load crates if he works with Joe? You'll have to explain this one to me, sonny boy. What's your story?
Well, my mother wanted me to come talk to you about an honest job, but I need some real money, so this ain't gonna cut it.
Them women, they're all the same. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
She doesn't want you hanging around with Joe, right? My mother was the same way. Look what become of me. Union boss. I got the whole fucking waterfront under my thumb. So how's Joe?
Pretty good, I guess.
How'd you meet up with him?
Oh, we go way back to the old neighborhood. I just come back from overseas and he's putting me up until I can get back on my feet.
Listen, you gotta understand, a person in my position has gotta be careful.
Certainly.
So you won't mind if I give Joe a call, right?
Nah, go ahead.
Now, where'd I put his number? Hey, here it is. He might not be home. That wouldn't be good. Hi, Joe. Hey, this is Derek. Listen, I got this guy here. What'd you say your name was?
Vito.
Vito. He's looking for a job. He says he's a friend of yours. A good friend. I just wanted to check with you first. Uh-huh. Sure. War hero and all that shit. All right. Thanks, then. I'll talk to you later. Sorry, pal. I had to check you out. Joe says you just come back from Italy. You must be able to handle yourself. You want to make a little more money? I got just the thing. The guys here at the port are supposed to pay a monthly fee to the barber, but half of them never cough it up. I need someone to give them a little nudge. $10 a man.
What if they don't need a haircut?
Well, then you'll have to convince them otherwise.
I see. What if somebody makes a fuss?
Then you kick the shit out of them.
Well, let's say you teach them a lesson that doesn't require that they miss work. You got it? Which is why Steve ain't doing the job. Right, Steve?
Right, boss.
Collect at least $150, I give you 50. Just for walking around, taking in the sea air and meeting new people. Easy fucking money, eh? What do you say?
Yeah, hey, it's better than lugging crates around.
All right, then. Get going.
I'm here to collect the fee for the barber.
I was just coming to pay. Actually, he's pretty good barber.
Thanks. Appreciate your cooperation. Pal, Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
What do I have to use a fucking barber for?
He'll spit on your head and make it shine. What do you want me to say?
Yeah, sure. Here you go. But tell Derek I should be getting a fucking discount.
Next time, try to pay on time, okay? Thanks. Hey, Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
You've got the wrong guy, pal. My wife cuts my hair.
Yeah, that's sweet. But while you work here, you get a haircut when Derek says.
Yeah! Okay, enough already. Here's your fucking money.
Yeah, glad you decided to reconsider. Hey, pal. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Look, asshole, I'm not in the mood. Why don't you get out of my face before you get hurt?
Ah, no can do, pal. Derek wants his money.
Derek can kiss my ass. What's that fat fuck gonna do? Have me killed?
Hey, you said it, not me.
Why don't you give it a try then, asshole?
Watch out!
Okay. Anybody else got a fucking problem with paying for the fucking barber?
Here's the money, boss man.
Good job. Here's your share. I watched you take care of Bill. You were good. Steve damn near got his ass kicked when he tried that. Right, Steve?
Right, Derek.
Here's a bonus for sorting him out.
Thanks.
The guy's been a real fucking pain.
Now get out of here, kid. I gotta be getting back to business. Say hello to your mother for me. Tell her you got yourself a job as my new assistant.
Yeah, will do. I'll see you later.
Hey, Vito, I almost forgot. Joe called. He wants you should meet him at Freddy's. Ain't got nothing else for you right now, kid.
The next time you and another person might be headed in the same general direction, plan on sharing the ride together. You'll save the gas in your tank and the rubber on your tires. Resources that are so very vital to the war effort. So the next time you're getting in the car by yourself, just remember this line. When you ride alone, you ride with Hitler. You can make a difference.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, where the hell you been?
I came right over as soon as you called. What's going on?
You remember the wise guys we used to see when we was kids?
Yeah, why?
The guy we're meeting here is one of them. His name's Henry Tomasino. I think he's got something big for us.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah. We're done with the small-time jobs. It's time to make some real shuttle. Here, he's coming. Don't say nothing stupid.
Hey, Henry, how are you?
Hiya, Joe.
This the guy?
Yeah, this is Vito, an old friend of mine.
Good to meet you, Henry. You vouch for him?
Absolutely, Henry. Trust him with my life.
Okay, listen. I got a job for you. The money's good. I need gas stamps. They're worth a fortune now because of the gas shortage.
Where can we get them?
In the Office of Price Administration.
That's a federal government agency. Isn't that a little risky?
What? Too much for you?
No. Just trying to think of how we can pull it off.
It can't be that hard. The stamps are kept in the safe at night, but the keys are probably around here somewhere.
You got somebody inside?
Yeah, one of our guys. His sister works there.
Can she help us out?
Ask her yourself. Her name's Maria Agnello. Here's the address. Tell her I say you.
All right, what about the safe? What if the keys aren't there?
That's your problem.
But what's the job pay?
I'll give you $600 for 10,000 gallons worth of stamps.
Okay, we're in.
No, I need Vito to do this alone. I got another job for you, Joe.
So, what do you say, Vito?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, and don't forget to take a piece with you. You never know what's gonna happen. Better to be safe than sorry. I got beef.
Wait. This isn't some liquor store stick-up. I want this to be a clean job. If you kill anybody, your cut drops to a third. Gabish?
Yeah, I got it. No problem.
Okay, when you're done, you come back in, we'll settle up.
All right, I'll see
you. Good luck, Vito.
They'll come marching down Fifth Avenue, the United Nations in review. When this lovely dream has all come true, we'll be dancing the victory polka.
Dance the victory polka.
Shine, the merry throng.
Sing the victory polka.
Raise your voices loud, strong.
It's gonna be
a great hallelujah day
when
the boys have
all come on to stay.
The million bands begin to play.
We'll be dancing the victory polka. And when we flip
the torch of liberty,
Each flag down,
flying across the sea. When a man can proudly say, I'm free,
we'll be dancing the victory polka. And we will give a mighty cheer.
When a ration book is just a souvenir,
and we'll heave a mighty sigh. When each girl can be.
Yeah, can I help you?
Yeah, hello, ma'am. Henry Tomasino sent me. He said you might be able to help me with a little problem down at the Office of Price Administration.
Yeah, I heard about that. What do you need from me?
I need to get in there tonight.
All right, tell you what. My sister's in the hospital right now. If you give me a lift over there, I'll tell you everything you need to know. It's right across the street from the OPA, so it ain't like you're gonna be going out of your way.
Sure, no problem.
Okay, let's go. And take it easy behind the wheel, all right? I seen the way you kids drive these days. All right, kid. The place is locked up pretty tight at night, so you gotta get into the back.
They keep the back door open at night?
No, but the basement window usually is, so that's how you can get in. You're looking for the safe, right?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Lucky guess. It's on the top floor. So's the director's office. That's where the keys are.
Okay. So I go in through a window around the back, then head upstairs to the director's office, right?
Right. And be careful, there's guards in there at night. Don't let them see you.
Both mother and daughter, working for the young.
way Sean is mighty queer, like the Yankee girl done made a swoon when she heard her bingo croon, drinking rum and Coca-Cola. Go down Point Kumana, both mother and daughter, working for the Yankee dollar.
All right, kid, drop me at the hospital right here. The office is across the street. Okay, thanks for the ride, kid.
Thanks, Maria. I'll see you.
All night long, make tropic love. Next day, sit in hot sun and cool off, drinking rum and Coca-Cola. Go down Point Kumana, both mother and daughter, working for the Yankee dollar. Working
down while I finish my puzzle.
Ah, raspberries. I'm gonna go make the rounds.
Good riddance to you.
Okay, this is the director's office. This is where the key should be.
You got any plans for the weekend?
Yeah, gonna relax and watch me some television.
Well, you bought a television?
I sure did.
Man, those things cost as much as a car. How the hell did you afford it?
Mary's Uncle Lou passed away a few months back, left us some cash.
And you bought yourself a television with it.
All right, here's the key. Now I gotta get to the safe.
That's what I did. You ought to see this thing. 7-inch black and white screen gets all 3 channels.
Wow, sounds fascinating.
What, you mean you ain't gonna get one?
I'll stick with my newspaper and with my radio, thank you very much. This television's just a fad.
We'll see about that, sonny boy.
Yeah, so what does Mary think of it?
She ain't seen it yet.
Ah, damn it.
On that fancy television set of yours?
Mostly cartoons. They ain't got much on right now on account of the war.
Cartoons? All that money to watch some cartoons. Oh, man.
Salesman said when the war is over, they're supposed to start showing ball games on it, too.
Yeah, I'll believe it when I see it.
But listen, I was watching them cartoons, and it gave me an idea.
Oh, here we go. Okay, Einstein, let's hear it.
Now listen to this. What if you could control the cartoon?
What do you mean?
You know, control it. You could make the little guy on the screen do things. You could make him run around, drive a car, maybe even have him shoot a gun, shoot things with it.
Hey, you been sniffing glue? How the hell are they gonna do that?
Listen, I ain't worked that out yet. Look, you probably have to have some sort of box with buttons on it that controls the guy on the screen. I mean, one button would make him walk, the other would make him shoot, one would maybe make him gun.
Oh, yeah, that's your brilliant idea, huh? That sounds interesting, but it ain't never gonna happen.
Oh, yeah? I'm sure someone will figure it out someday, and you can mark my words on that.
Uh-huh. Sure they will. Right after they put a guy on the moon.
Yeah, all right. I'm gonna get back to my crossword puzzle here.
Yeah, all right. Don't hurt yourself with that number two pencil.
Thank you. This is the Empire Bay Police Department. We have you surrounded. Come out with your hands up. If you do not surrender immediately, we will open fire.
Nice to see you.
Well,
how'd you make out?
Things got out of hand. There's nothing I could do about it.
We had an agreement. Remember? You only get a third of the money if there's any shooting.
Let's see what we got here. Ah, shit. Something wrong?
You bet your ass there's something wrong. These stamps you took have an expiration date. And that date is tomorrow.
So, what exactly does that mean?
It means they're gonna be fucking worthless. But wait. If you can get them to the gas station attendants by midnight, they'll be able to stamp them and redeem them. You better bring them to every gas station in town. They gotta get there by midnight or we're screwed. If you don't sell them in time, you get nothing.
Wait a minute. That wasn't our deal. You didn't say anything about any expiration dates.
Well, shit happens, doesn't it? Look, you pull this off, I won't forget it. Trust me. Now get going. The faster you unload them, the more money you get.
Okay, take care.
Radio News, I'm Lowell Harris. A surprise attack on Allied Air Forces made for a deadly reprisal during Operation Boltenblatt just over a month ago. German Luftwaffe planes surged in early morning to the surprise of Allied forces in France, Belgium, and Holland. 200 Allied aircraft were destroyed, and another 150 were damaged before Allied fighter pilots took to the skies to exact swift retribution. When the smoke cleared, almost 300 of the Kaiser's flying brigade were...
Hey, I got some extra gas stamps. Interested?
Yeah, sure. I'm interested.
All right, here you go. Fork over the dough.
Sure. Here's your money.
Thanks, pal. Now forget you saw me.
See ya!
Man, why ain't they giving me no directions up there? Bullshit.
Let's move down to some big town where they love a gal by the cut of her clothes, and I'll stand out in buttons and bows. And skirts that I've homespun, but I'll love you longer, stronger, where your friends don't tote a gun. My bumpy mounts, the buckboard bounce, and the cactus hurts my toes. Let's bamboos where gals keep you close, silks and satins and linens and shows, and I'm all yours in buttons and bows.
The robin have seen the sunbeams that shine. They're yours, they're mine.
Hey, interested in buying some gas stamps?
Sure. Just keep this between you and me, all right?
No problem. Just make sure you do the same.
Sure. Sounds good to me.
See ya!
Listen, I got these extra gas stamps. You want them? They're yours. Cheap.
Yeah, all right. I'm good with that.
All right, here you go. And keep your mouth shut about this, all right?
Sure thing, buddy. It'll be our secret.
It better be.
See ya!
Delta Radio. Stay tuned for more Radio with Soul. Delta Radio, Empire Bank.
Hey, you in the market for some surplus gas stamps?
Sure. Where'd you get them? On second thought, I don't even want to know.
Smart man. All right, now fork over the dough.
Yeah, all right. Just hope I don't get in trouble for this.
Don't worry about it. Just keep your mouth shut.
See ya!
Cut out on my sugar, now he's messing with my ham. I got the red sugar, blue as I can be. Oh, me, I've got the red sugar. I got to live on 40 ounces of any kind of meat. Those 40 little ounces gotta last me all the week. I gotta cut out on my jelly. It takes sugar to make it sweet. I'm gonna steal all your jelly, baby, and rob you of your meat. I got the ration blues. Blue as I. Wake up in the morning with my jelly.
Hey, I got some extra gas stamps. Interested?
Yeah, sure. I'm interested.
All right, here you go. Fork over the dough.
Sure. Here's your money.
Thanks, pal. Now forget you saw me.
Good evening, sir.
Goodbye.
Pursuit of a hit-and-run driver.
Copy that.
Song now as British
British Spitfire fighter planes have finally taken out a key Nazi factory, one that produced fuel for none other than the dreaded EP-2 rocket. After several weeks of merciless punishment by this long-range menace, Londoners can breathe a sigh of relief now that the Royal Air Force appears to have severely crippled the Nazi terror for the foreseeable future. For Press Radio News, I'm Lowell Herring.
Good evening, sir.
Hey, pal, do you mind?
Hey, interested in buying some gas stamps?
Sure. Just keep this between you and me, all right?
No problem. Just make sure you do the same.
Sure. Sounds good to me.
All right, that's the last of them. At least I got some cash. I should head back to Joe's.
Jeez.
Look at this. Didn't know Joe could even write.
We got another job. Something really big. Stop by Freddy's tonight. Bring a piece and some lockpicks.
All right, guys, I think we'll end this here. And I'll record another video later on today and put up there. I think I got two up here now, so we'll catch you next time for some more Mafia 2.